Detective Recapped here. Today, I'm going to explain a mystery romance film called Killing Me Softly. Spoilers ahead. Watch out and take care. As a group of mountaineers climbs a snowy cliff, a woman describes how the brain dies from a lack of oxygen once a person reaches a certain altitude. The brain just shuts down, and the body goes along with it. The woman says she can't stop thinking about what it must have been like, and the person she's talking to asks her to start from the beginning, so she tells him her whole story. An American woman named Alice describes her life in London with her boyfriend, Jake. Alice says she grew up on the plains in Indiana and that she's always been a Flatlander. She had already been staying in London for a year and a half, and the first 6 months have been hard on her, but that changed upon meeting Jake. Alice is a CD-ROMs and website designer, while Jake is an engineer. One day, Alice is about to cross the street when she encounters a charming stranger. She is completely enthralled by him as they cross, and his very presence distracts her even after they parted ways. Alice starts heading inside her office, but she takes another look at him and sees him entering a bookstore. After being continually distracted and unsettled at work, she finally heads out. Peeking inside the bookstore, she sees that the man is waiting in line with his friend. He looks at her, embarrassing her, so she steps back and hides. When she's finally about to go inside, Alice finds herself face to face with the man, with only the glass separating them. She accepted the stranger's offer to get inside a cab with him. Inside the car, the sensual tension between them hangs heavy in the air. After the man takes Alice home, he grabs her from behind and starts kissing her. Alice then kisses him back, and it isn't long before they make torrid and passionate love. Once they're done, Alice dresses and turns away, embarrassed and perhaps even regretful. After softly asking her to face him, the stranger helps her put on her undergarment. Maintaining a gentle tone, he invites her to come back to his house again, but Alice keeps insisting that she can't. In the end, he assures her that she can come over whenever she wants and that he'll be there when she does. That night, Alice makes love with Jake, but it feels different and not nearly as thrilling as it did when she slept with the stranger. The following day, Alice passes by the bookstore with the hopes of seeing the stranger again. Instead, she sees a poster of him along with his book. There, she learns that the man is Adam Tallis, a mountain climber who saved 6 people with no oxygen. After buying Adam's book, Alice goes straight to Adam's house, where she finds him waiting for her by the door. The two make love once more, and afterwards, they lie on the floor. Now resting, Alice tells Adam that she bought his book. He corrects her, saying that it's not his book, he's just in it. When she comments that it looks good, he simply retorts that people died. Adam gets up to smoke, then starts telling Alice what happened. According to Adam, he lost the whole group of mountaineers he was with, including the woman he loved, Françoise Colette. There was no room for error, everything had been checked, yet he still doesn't know what happened. He then asks Alice if he knows what it's like over 20,000 feet, and when Alice shakes her head, Adam stands and snatches his goldfish from the aquarium. Adam shows Alice the fish as it struggles to breathe, saying that's exactly how it feels. Without air, the brain cells die. Once the brain shuts down, the rest of the body follows. He then puts the fish back, saying that it's been 2 years, but the feeling doesn't go away. Alice then kisses Adam before finally confessing that she lives with someone. Adam doesn't seem to mind, though, and when Alice begins putting on her underwear, he tells her not to. At home, Alice unexpectedly tells Jake that she has to leave him. Shocked, Jake walks up to her and hugs her, and as Alice cries, Jake insists that they're perfect together and that he wants to marry her. Stifling a sob, she admits that she met somebody, and while Jake tries to keep himself from exploding, all Alice could say is that she didn't mean to hurt him. Finally, Jake lets out his anger and turns over a small table, while Alice only listens to him before walking out. After heading to Adam's place, Alice meets his sister, Deborah. She lets Alice know that Adam isn't there at the moment before inviting her inside. There, Deborah explains that Adam's having some work done on his place, so he stayed in her house while she was gone. As she arranges her photos, Deborah explains Adam's aversion to looking at them. Alice points to a woman in one of the pictures, asking if it's Françoise. Deborah confirms this and tells her that Adam can't look at the photos because it's hard for him to see Françoise. While he's a brave guy, he can get scared of remembering, and he forgets that the accident wasn't solely his fault. Deborah adds that she was with the mountaineers when the accident happened and that Françoise was her best friend. Finally, Deborah calls Alice by name for the first time, and she compliments her on her beauty, saying that she can see why Adam fell so hard for her. After that, Alice asks her for Adam's address. Upon finding Adam's place, Alice rings his doorbell several times, but there is no answer. When Adam finally shows up, he hugs Alice tightly as she tells him that she left Jake. She starts telling Adam that he's hurting her, but he ignores this and starts eagerly kissing her. As usual, Alice returns his kiss, ends up against a wall, and the two sleep together again. The following morning, Alice wakes up alone in bed, and when she gets out, she sees Adam downstairs just coming in with a woman. Adam introduces Joanna Noble to Alice, and Joanna informs her that she's a reporter from The Guardian, tasked to interview Adam about his Himalayan cleanup project. After greeting the reporter, Alice tries looking for a shirt in Adam's closet but finds it locked. Adam watches Alice going through his drawer and finding a key, only to put it back. Finally, she settles on the shirt that's on the chair, and when Adam's phone rings, she informs him about it. Adam then tells her to answer it for him, and when she does, there's nobody on the other line. Soon, Alice tells him that she needs to go to work, and Adam kisses her before asking her to see him afterwards. Adam takes Alice wall climbing, where Deborah sees her and helps her put on her harness. As Adam gets down from the wall, he gently pulls Deborah aside, saying he'll take it from there. When he finished helping Alice with her harness, Alice gets introduced to Klaus, and she tells him that she liked his book. Later on, Alice meets up with her friend, Sylvie. She disapproves of Alice destroying her and Jake's lives by letting go of a man who loves her just for a good bang. Alice tries to defend herself by saying that when she's with Adam, everything is just more. As the two leave the bar, a man suddenly mugs Alice before immediately running away. Witnessing the whole thing, Adam chases the guy and catches up to him by the telephone booth, where he smashes the mugger's head against the glass and beats him up badly. Alice and Sylvie catch up to them, and Alice tells Sylvie to call the cops while she runs to Adam, telling him to stop. When Adam finally relents, he embraces Alice and kisses her deeply, promising her that that will never happen again and that he will protect her. The sight shocks Sylvie, but Adam and Alice pay her no mind and start walking away. Out of the blue, Adam proposes to Alice, saying the sooner they get married, the better, and Alice joyfully accepts. One day, Alice receives a mysterious letter, asking her what she really knows about Adam. She shows Adam the telegram and informs him about the call from that morning, saying someone was on the line, but they weren't talking. Adam says someone is just scaring her, and as he lets her in his car, he reminds Alice to tell him if anything like that happens again. They then drive to Adam's family church by the countryside to get married, where they have two strangers as their witnesses. After the ceremony, they get dressed at the way station for hikers, where Adam takes a picture of Alice while still naked. They change into their hiking outfits, and as Alice recalls what she did with Adam to celebrate their marriage, the person she's telling her story to is surprised to learn that they went hiking on their wedding day. As they walk in the wilderness, Alice quickly gets worn out and sits down. Because of that, Adam promises to give her an unforgettable honeymoon, then teaches her how to conserve her energy. Adam then goes ahead, leaving Alice by herself. Since she wants Adam to be proud of her, she follows the trail for hours until she finally reaches his cabin. Inside, Adam makes an anchor and gives Alice a long piece of silk, explaining that the anchor is for catching a falling body. Without hesitation, Alice lets Adam wrap the silk around her neck and hook it on the anchor, giving him control over her body. She lets Adam decide when she can and cannot breathe, and finally, after making love, Adam tells her that he loves her. Alice continues her story, recounting that they returned to London and Joanna Noble's article came out. She was happier than she'd ever been. As Alice gets home one day, she receives another mysterious letter, warning her that marrying Adam was a mistake. She quickly calls Jake but gets surprised when Sylvie answers the phone. Sylvie tells Alice that she and Jake have been seeing each other, but Alice doesn't seem to mind. From the shower, Adam calls Alice and tells her they'll be late, so Alice ends the call with Sylvie. This time, Alice doesn't show Adam the letter. They attend a gathering together, and Alice feels completely out of place. After looking at a picture of Adam with Francoise, Alice goes to the bathroom, where Deborah sees her wiping off her lipstick. When Deborah asks if she's okay, Alice tells her that she has a headache. To help her, Deborah massages her hand and neck, and once she's better, Alice thanks her sister-in-law. Then, Deborah asks Alice to close her eyes, and when she does, Deborah puts a necklace around her neck. Downstairs, Klaus proposes a toast to Alice, announcing that she has conquered Adam. When Adam sees Alice with his sister, he suddenly gets uncomfortable but hugs them both anyway. While in a meeting, Alice receives a call from Joanna and informs her that she's just received a weird note about Adam's article. Alice receives the note through the fax machine. It's from a woman who claims that Adam had defiled her, and she's asking Joanna to report the truth. Alice then receives the continuation of the letter, which shows the name and contact number of the sender, Michelle Stowe, who says that she'll reveal the real story. Upset, Alice leaves the office and goes to Michelle's place. Meanwhile, Adam calls Alice's office and learns that she's just left. Posing as Joanna, Alice interviews Michelle about the incident. Michelle recounts it to Alice, saying she and Adam were kissing at a party that time and before she knew it, Adam was pulling her into the bushes and started forcing himself on her until he overpowered her. Michelle then sarcastically asks Alice if she'll write an article about it, adding that they can make some money out of it. However, Alice tells her it doesn't work that way, especially since she has no proof against Adam. Later that day, Alice meets Joanna, who is unhappy about what Alice did. She tells Alice that she could get fired for her carelessness, and Alice apologizes to her. Alice says she's just really curious, but Joanna tells her that curiosity gets people killed. Alice resolves that she should trust Adam, and the two women prepare to leave. Meanwhile, someone outside the coffee shop puts out a cigarette. That night, Alice contemplates how little she knows about Adam. She's musing about how everything she knows about him either came from a book, a newspaper, or even shreds of information from other people. With a strong desire to know more, Alice takes the key that she saw in the drawer the other day and opens Adam's closet. In there, she finds a box of letters from a woman named Adele Blanchard. As she reads them, Alice learns that Adam used to have an affair with a married woman. Adele is telling Adam in her letters that she's going back to her husband, and that what they're doing is dangerous. Suddenly, Adam arrives, and Alice hurriedly puts back the letters inside the closet, struggling to close it properly. When she finally does, Alice greets Adam as if nothing happened. The following morning, Adam informs Alice that he called her office the previous day, and her colleague said she was out. Alice stammers that she had a doctor's appointment but wasn't able to leave her meeting. Skeptical, Adam asks where exactly the meeting was held, and Alice nervously answers that it was at the Hilton. Though he remains unconvinced, Adam apologizes to her for being nosy. He then shows Alice her necklace and asks where she got it from, and Alice says Deborah gave it to her. For a moment, there's a trace of disbelief and uneasiness on Adam's face, but it disappears quickly as he smiles, saying Deborah has good taste. As Adam reads the newspaper, Alice tells him about Michelle Stowe's note and accusation. Adam is quick to deny it, saying it never happened, and that he's not surprised that Michelle contacted her. Adam then apologizes to Alice for having to hear that story, and before she could reply, Klaus shows up to take Adam to a talk show. Once they're gone, Alice goes through Adam's drawer again to find the key to the closet, but it isn't there. Suddenly, she hears the sound of the wind chime from the front door, and she immediately checks to see if Adam is back. When she opens the door, Alice finds a package on the floor, containing a letter that asks her how far she'll let Adam go and a long piece of silk with bloodstains, similar to the one Adam used on her during their honeymoon. Alice then quickly calls the directory inquiries and asks if they have a listing for Adele Blanchard on Marchmont Road. Posing as Joanna again, Alice goes to Adele's house, where Adele's mother greets her. Alice learns from her that Adele's been missing for 8 months, and after Adele's mother invites her inside, she tells Alice that Adele hasn't even contacted her husband, Michael. Then, she shows her Adele's photo album, where she finds Adam in one of Adele's wedding pictures. Adele's mother says her daughter used to climb with Adam all the time, but that stopped 2 years after she got married. She says Michael got fed up with Adele's mountain climbing, so in the end, Adele chose to stop. To her horror, Alice also sees a naked photo of Adele standing beside an angel statue at the place where they got married. Then, Adele's mother mentions that Adam called her, asking for updates on the investigation. When Adele's mother tells Alice that Adam is also coming, Alice immediately excuses herself and leaves, secretly taking 2 photos of Adele. She throws away her package before boarding the train while repeatedly looking behind her. That evening, Alice is startled when she suddenly sees Adam in the dark corner of their house, smoking. Adam then puts out his cigarette and picks Alice up before binding her on the table. Alice tries to protest, but Adam ignores her and accuses her of being with another man. When Alice denies it, Adam asks her why she keeps sneaking around, and that's when she admits that she's found Adele's letters. Furious, Adam goes upstairs to retrieve the letters and starts throwing them down to Alice, saying he has nothing to hide. When he goes back down, Alice asks him to untie her, but Adam only sits on the floor and cries, lamenting over how she wouldn't be in that position if she trusted him. Trying to get Adam's sympathy, Alice says she just wanted to know him more so that she could love him more. While he's crying, Adam assures Alice that he's hers, and that he loves her so much, he can break her neck. Adam then asks if she likes what they're doing, but she doesn't answer his question and instead tells him that she needs to pee. After Adam unties her, Alice escapes his house through the fire exit, and Adam quickly goes after her, begging her to stop. As she hides from Adam, Alice witnesses how he could lose his temper over small things and throw a fit. Finally, it's revealed that the person Alice has been talking to is a senior police officer, and she explains that that's when she came to him. She asks him if they can open Adele Blanchard's case, but the officer says it's not easy to open a case like Adele's. Alice retorts that Adam killed Adele, but the officer says she has no proof of that. Still determined to have Adam arrested, Alice tells him that Adam forced himself on Michelle, but the officer curtly replies that Michelle never reported it. The only proof she has is the 2 photographs of Adele, which prove nothing. The officer then shows Adam through the double-sided glass, telling the officers about Alice's escape in the other interrogation room. She hears Adam saying he loves her, and the officer tells Alice that even though he believes Adam has the potential for violence, he isn't sure if he's a murderer. After closing the blinds, the officer informs Alice that they can only keep Adam for a few hours, adding that she's accusing a hero while providing no evidence. With no one to turn to, Alice asks for Deborah's help to know the truth about Adam. After learning from Deborah that Francoise was with someone else, Alice infers that Francoise left Adam, so he killed her. Deborah agrees with her, then she shows Alice 2 different anchors used in climbing, one of which is made of cheap material. She says Adam could have switched the anchors, killing Francoise and her group. Finally, Deborah advises Alice to leave Adam for her own good. Scared, Alice tells Deborah about Adele and gives her Adele's pictures. Alice still thinks that Adam killed her, and she must have been buried at the location in the picture, at St. Edmunds. Then, Alice asks Deborah to come with her to find Adele. On their way to St. Edmunds, Deborah confesses to sending Alice the notes. She knows about Adam's violence, and she wants her to get away from him. Back at Deborah's place, Adam finds the 2 photos of Adele, and after quickly realizing where Alice is headed, he follows her. At St. Edmunds, Alice finds a body buried in the dirt, wearing a necklace like the one Deborah gave her. When Alice confronts her about it, Deborah ominously says that Adele didn't have to die if only she'd told her that she was going back to Michael. With a sneer, Deborah says she gave Adele a necklace, too, and that she found it beautiful just like Alice did. With Alice demanding to know what Deborah did, the 2 women start fighting and hitting each other. Deborah aggressively admits to sleeping with her brother when they were kids, adding that she's the one who gave him his first piece of silk. As they struggle, Deborah yells that Adam is hers and attempts to hit Alice with a shovel, but Adam shows up and tackles her to the ground. Alice then runs away and Adam hits Deborah across the face, saying he was never hers. As he starts looking for Alice, Deborah is about to hit him at the back with a shovel, but Alice shoots her with a flare gun. Deborah dies in Adam's arms, leaving him stunned and devastated. He confesses to Alice that he and Deborah used to go there together, and with a betrayed look, Adam says that he thought Alice just had to trust him. Deborah's body is taken by the cops the following day, and so is Adam. 2 years later, Alice and Adam see each other again at the airport, as he's going up the escalator while she is going down. Neither of them says anything, but they just look at each other. When Adam reaches the top, he stays there for a moment and looks at Alice one last time before walking away. Meanwhile, Alice starts thinking that a flatlander like her can't live at a high altitude, right where Adam is. Subscribe to watch more videos like this. Turn on notifications. And leave a like, it really helps the channel out. Thank you for watching.